An analyst now applauding the rate cut decision of the Federal Reserve. Eric Diton, President and Managing Director of the Wealth Alliance, says this is 100% the right move.
He's got a dual mandate, right? He wants close to full employment as he can get with stable prices. That's what he's balancing. And he finally said, we are now in equilibrium. I've been more worried about inflation until now. Now I'm equally worried about the employment picture as I am about prices. And that's good. We need to hear that. And what we're talking about now is a median estimate by his people in the Fed of 4.4% on the Fed funds by year end, 3.4 end of next year.
Meanwhile, here at home, the Fed's policy easing is seen to boost the Philippine Central Bank's own rate cuts. Alfred Garcia of AP Securities says that's good for the economy, the stock market, as well as the peso.
If that's the scenario we're looking at, we might see 225 bips cut. But we are of the opinion that the PSP will likely continue on its path with our forecast that we're only cutting by 25 bips for this year, another 25 bips. That is so that we'll see the interest rate differential to widen back to the more normal levels of around 2 to 3%.
Filipinos, one of the top producers of electronic waste in Southeast Asia, are urged to dispose of such waste properly. More from Izzy Lee.
100 kilograms of electronic waste or e-waste are dumped at this junk shop in North Caloocan every week. The owner, Rene, says they get most of the waste from companies and households. E-waste refers to broken or unused electronic devices such as cell phones, computers, and televisions.
Dinadala po namin dito sa aming warehouse to dismantle, and then dinadala po namin sa isang company rin na which is nag-e-export at sila na rin po ang nagpa-process.
According to the 2024 Global E-Waste Monitor, the Philippines is among the top three producers of e-waste in Southeast Asia, generating 540 million kilograms of e-waste, or around 5 to 10 kilos for each Filipino, higher than the 3.9 kilos recorded in 2019. Environmental group Ban Toxics adds, e-waste contains hazardous or harmful chemicals that can be inhaled, ingested, or come into contact with the skin.
Napakadelikado nito, lalong-lalo na kung may mga illegal or unwarranted na pagdi-dismantle, pagbabasag, pagbabaklas nitong mga electronic and electrical waste. And at the same time, ay posibleng ito pa ay umabot sa ating kalikasan or sa ating environment sa pamamagitan ng wastewaters natin dito, kalupaan kung saan man sila nagdi-dismantle.
It is recommended to bring e-waste to a treatment, storage, and disposal or TSD facility that has the capability to properly dispose of it. At one such facility in North Caloocan, the e-waste is weighed and tested with a device to determine the harmful chemicals it contains. If the levels are too high, it cannot be recycled and is sent directly for disposal. There is also a dismantling area where e-waste is taken apart. The parts of electronic devices are collected and sent to the partner recycling facility in Laguna.
Ito ay na-establish, formalize yung mga pagbabaklas at maiwasan yung mga pagtatapon ng mga electric gadgets sa mga creek. Before kasi, yung mga tao is nagbabaklas outside.
The problem, according to Ban Toxics, is there are only a few TSD facilities in the country, which are also inaccessible to the general public. According to the Environmental Management Bureau of the Philippine Department of Environment and Natural Resources, there are 78 registered TSD facilities nationwide, including 7 in NCR. They hope to increase this number. On Wednesday, the DENR completed its project on hazardous waste management in partnership with the United Nations Industrial Development Organization, or UNIDO, safely disposing over 100 cathode ray tubes, or CRTs, from old TVs and monitors containing harmful chemicals. The agency also reminded the public to avoid simply disposing of their e-waste.
i-store lang natin yan at lahat ng barangay, makipag-coordinate po sila sa barangay para ma-store doon, and then yung mga barangay, alam naman po nilang gagawin dyan. They will just be coordinating with our offices sa EMB ng bawat regions, and then kami na po bahala doon. EMB will now be coordinating with this TSDs para po makolekta at para po natin matreat.
There are also initiatives like the E-Waste Project, which conducts an e-waste collection drive every year with drop-off points in various locations in the University of the Philippines, Diliman.
After namin i-store, like temporary storage lang kasi kami, and ibibigay pa namin yung sa recyclers. Sa mga hindi naman pwede nang magamit, ang ginagawa nila is sinisira na talaga nila, hinihiwala yung mga different materials like mga plastic, mga circuit boards, at saka mga metals para properly dispose of at saka hindi mabalik sa landfill, which is yun yung ayaw natin magamit.
Ban Toxics meanwhile advises Filipinos to separate e-waste from other types of trash. Avoid disassembling or burning e-waste and dumping e-waste in vacant lots or throwing it in waterways. Easily, ABS-CBN News.
Another wave of device explosions rocks Lebanon. After the pager attacks on Tuesday, dozens of walkie-talkies used by Hezbollah members exploded across Beirut. Local authorities say at least 20 people are killed and over 450 are injured. Some explosions took place during funerals of those who died in the pager explosions on Tuesday. Hezbollah blames Israel for the attacks, which have stoked fears of a wider war in the Middle East. U.S. President Joe Biden now looking at his options after his term ends. Biden famously announced in July that he was stepping aside from the 2024 presidential race following pressure from party leaders. At a White House reception celebrating Hispanic Heritage Month, Biden jokingly asked Hollywood star and successful businesswoman Jessica Alba for a job.
And by the way, Jessica, thank you for the introduction. She's an actor, producer, advocate, author, and she knows how to build companies. Jessica, if I'm really good, maybe you can get me a job in this. God love you.